Welcome back. I want to apologize. That last problem, I think I rushed it a little bit because I have to get under this 10-minute YouTube limit. But let me know. Send me a message on that last video if you don't think the explanation was as satisfying as you would like it to be, or if you're still confused. But with that said, let me move on. Problem number 9. Problem number 9 on page 461. So problem number 9. Say the decimal number above, and they wrote. See, they say 5.10100100001000001, and they, it keeps going. The decimal number above consists of only ones and zeros to the right of the decimal point. The first one is followed by 10. The second one is followed by 20, right? Second one is followed by 20. Third one followed by 30. And so forth. What is the total number of zeros between the 98th, and 101st? One in this decimal number. Well, the first one is followed by 10. The second one is followed by 20. The third one is followed by 30, right? So the 50th one is going to be followed by 50 zeros, right? That the nth one is followed by n zeros. So the 98th is going to be followed by 98 zeros, right? And then the 99th, so you're going to have, a 1, then you're going to have 98 zeros, then you're going to have the 99th one. And that's going to be followed by 99 zeros, right? That's just the pattern that they set up. Then you're going to have the 100th one. That's going to be followed by 100 zeros. And then you're going to have the 101st one, right? And we don't care about the zeros that are after the 101st one, because they said how many zeros are between the 98th one and the 101st one. So, I mean, another way to draw it is, we had a bunch of, we had a bunch of zeros on this. And then this is the 98th one, 98th. And then we're going to have, zero, da, 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 a bunch of zero. We're going to have 98 zeros here. Then you're going to have a 1. Then you're going to have a bunch of zeros. This time you're going to have 99 zeros. This is going to be the 99th. This is the 99th one. Then you have the 100th one, which is followed by 100 zeros. 100 zeros. And then you have the 101st one. And we don't care about the zeros after it. So this is how many zeros are in between. We just have to add up this. See, 8 plus 9 is 17. So it's, 98 plus 99 is, 207? So it's 307 zeros. Is that one of the choices? Oh, no, sorry. I'm doing my math. 98 plus, see, this is how I know it's late at night, and I should be in bed. But 98 plus 99 is 197, plus 100 is 297. 297. So that's how many zeros are between the 98th and 101st one in this decimal number. Problem 10. Let me switch colors. This color is making me sleepy. Number 10. F of x is equal to 3 minus 2x squared over x. For all non-zero x, then f of 2. Well, we just take a 2, and everywhere we see, f of 2, we're just taking a 2 and sticking it here. So everywhere we see an x, we replace it with a 2. So it becomes 3 minus 2. We put a 2 in there. Let me switch colors for emphasis. Whoops. 2 squared over 2. Oh, what? That's not the same purple. Over 2. That's not the same point. This is it. Over 2. And if I wanted to, just so you know where that 2 came from, that's f of 2. Right? Everywhere where there was an x, I just replaced it with a 2. And now I just evaluate this. So 3 minus 2 times 2 squared. So that 2 squared is 4 over 2. So 3 minus 8 over 2. Equals, what's 3 minus 8 is minus 5, so it's minus 5 over 2. And that is choice D. Okay, looks like we have a geometry problem for number 11. Image. Okay, problem number 11. Let me draw this. And there's two lines like this. And like this. And these lines are perpendicular. X degrees. Y degrees. This line is L, this line is M. It says, in the figure above, L is perpendicular to N, right? L is perpendicular to N, this is a 90 degree angle. And X is greater than 90 degrees. So this angle is larger than 90 degrees. So they didn't draw it that way. So this is actually probably angling down a bit. Which of the following must be true? Y is less than 90 degrees. So let's see. If this is, so it's interesting because who cares what's happening up here, right? If you have a line, let me just draw it like this. Let me draw it with the lines, actually. Let me draw it like, if you have one line like this, and then this line like this. If this is right here is x, x is greater than 90 degrees, and this is y, we know that these two angles are going to be supplementary to each other, that they add up to 180, right? X plus y is equal to 180 degrees. So if x is greater than 90, x is greater than 90, then we know that y has to be less than 90, right? So that's what we know is true. We can look at the other choices. Y is definitely not going to be greater than 90. Y is definitely not going to be equal to 90. If y is equal to 90 and x is greater than 90, then these two angles are going to be greater than 180 degrees, which we know it can't be. N is parallel, n is perpendicular to m. We know that's not true because if this is 90 degrees, then this is also 90 degrees. But this angle is a corresponding angle, but it's not the same. So they're not parallel lines. This line is actually, you know, I should have drawn it like this. Oh, no, actually, I drew a straight line when I didn't want to. It's going to be skewed down like this, right? Because this x degrees is more than 90. And then L is parallel to m, and we also know that's not the case for the same reason. So it's choice A. All right. Let's see if I can fit in this last problem within the 10-minute window. Problem number 12. In the xy plane, the line with the equation y is equal to 5x minus 10 crosses the x-axis at the point with the coordinates a, b. So this is where it crosses the x-axis. X-axis. So it's where it crosses the x-axis. What is the value of a? Okay. So when something crosses the x-axis, what's the value of b? What's the y value? Well, the y value we know is going to be 0, right? I mean, I could draw that if I draw coordinates. And if this is a line, let me draw the line. If say the line looks something like this, where something crosses the x-axis, that's going to be right here when y equals 0. So all we have to do is set y equals 0 and solve for x. So when y equals, we get 0 is equal to 5x minus 10. 5x is equal to 10. X is equal to 2. So this is the point right here. This is the point. 2 comma 0. So A, choice A is going to be equal to choice D, which is 2, which is the answer. I think that's all the time I have for in this video, because the next one looks like I'll have to draw a table. And so I will see you soon.